Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create this animal-themed bingo chart in Word. So the first thing I'm going to do is insert the table for the actual bingo grid. So let's go up to Insert, Table, and I'm going to select 5 by 5. And there's my table. Now, you can see my cursor in the top left here. All I'm going to do is hit the return key a few times because we're actually going to move this table down the page. And it does make it a lot easier if you do this first. Okay, select the table by clicking on this top left square. Go to Table Layout. Go to the height. And I want to make roughly a square. So let's put 3.18 in because you can see that the width is 3.18. 3.18, press Enter. Okay, we've gone down a little bit too far, so let's just bring that up. There we go. Perfect. You can see at the bottom we've made another page here, but actually I want my table to lie about here. So all I'm going to do is take my cursor over to the left and hover over my rulers. If you can't see rulers, go to View and select Ruler and just hover the cursor between the two, the white and the grey section, and click and then drag, and as you pull down you can see that second page disappears because you've actually reduced your margins, allowing a bit more space in the body of your document. So the next thing I'm going to do is insert some text, and then we'll get on to all of the colors in a little while. So go to Insert, Word Art, click on the drop down, and let's just select this black one, and we'll just put in animal to start with. We'll customize that and then we'll copy and paste it to do the bingo one as well. So I'm just going to extend that, go to the Home tab. I'm going to change the font, click on the drop down, and I'm going to change it to this one here called Atma. And I'm also going to increase the size of the font to 140, press Enter. There we go. And then we're going to change the curvature, go to Shape Format, Text Effects, click on the drop down, go to Transform, and then I'm going to select this one here, it says arch up, and then on the left hand side here you can see that there's a yellow box here. Now you can use this yellow box by moving it backwards and forwards to increase or decrease the curvature of your word. Sometimes it does need a little bit of experimentation, but I'm just going to go up now, go back to the Home tab. I'm going to make that bold. And the other thing is that if you move the box up and down, it will adjust the curvature of your word as well, so you can adjust it in that way as well. And this is all about personal preference. So the next thing is to change the color. So I'm going to go to Shape Format and all the way over to Format Pane. And here on the bucket icon, make sure on Text Options here, you've got Text Fill, which is the inside color, and you've got Text Outline, which is obviously the outline color. So we're going to fill the text, and we're going to fill the text with a gradient. So go to Gradient Fill, and as you can see, because I've done this before, my gradients are already here. So what I've done is I've selected Linear Gradient. In the direction, I've just selected top to bottom. So let's just move that over, and you can see I've chosen this one here. Now all you do, you have these markers. To select one, just click on it. You can see it's got an orange marker around it. Go to Color, click on the drop down, and then you've got all of your color options. I've selected an orange here. If you don't see the color you like, go to More Colors. You've got your color wheel here. You can select any color from the color wheel by moving this cursor. You can also use the Brightness and Darken slider as well. And the color you select will appear in this square here. So I've got my color there. And then again, I've selected this one. And then I've simply selected the yellow color. Let me just move this in. I've just selected the yellow color here. What I've also done, I've just adjusted my slider. You can move these sliders left and right and you can see what impact that has on my word. And then I'm also going to select a solid line. So go down to Text Outline, click on Solid Line. And you can see again, I've gone over to Color, click on the drop down, select the color of choice. And you can see at the moment that outline's quite thin. So I'm going to increase that to, let's say, let's go to 5. Let's go to 3, actually, I think it's about 3, yep. So let's try 3, perfect. And you can see there's already a shadow behind this text, so we don't have to add any of that. Once you're happy with the layout of your text, simply select it You can use Command or Control C, deselect Command and Control V to copy this, or you can just simply hold down your Alt or Option key, click and drag, and then you will make a copy. Now for the bingo, I didn't actually make a curve on it, so I'm going to select it, go back up to Text Effects, go to Transform, and then select No Transform. And then I'm going to alter this text, and I'm just going to go to the Home tab. And I'm going to reduce the size of it to 80, press Enter. And then I'm going to change this to the word bingo. Reduce the size of my text box, just move that up. The next thing to do is just to insert the cloud behind. So go to Insert, Shapes. I'm not being very accurate with where I'm putting everything at the moment because I'll come back and align everything at the end. There's no point in fiddling around with it now because it all moves and adjusts. So I'm going to use this cloud icon here in Basic Shapes. Click on it, click and drag. And you can make this fit exactly where your space is or how you want it to lie in your document. And make sure you've selected this. If you go up to the menu now, it says Format Shape. So now we can format the shape and we can go to Solid Fill Color, go to Color. And on this one, I'm going to select this color here. And for the line, I'll select one of these oranges at the bottom. So as you can see, the cloud is in front of our text. If I move this out of the way, you can see it's there, but it's just gone in front. So we need to move it back and behind. So select it, go to Shape Format, go to Send Backwards, click on the drop down and select Center Back. And there you have your cloud behind the text. So the next thing to do is to format the table. So I'm going to select the table again by clicking on that top left square. If you can't see it, it's because you haven't selected, just put your cursor inside the table. Select it all, go up to Table Design, and then go along to this section here. Now, this one here allows you to change the borderline color. So I've selected orange. This one here tells you the thickness of your borderlines. So I've selected 4.5. And then you can also choose the style of that border. You don't have to go with what I choose. There's lots of styles here you can choose from. Then go over to this border icon here, click on the drop down, and you've got all the separate borders, left and right, etc. I'm just going to select all borders, and you can see all my borders now have been colored. Again, I've made an extra page. I'm just going to move this down, and I'm just going to zoom out. There you go. Oh, I see. It's gone over, so we need to pull that up. There we go. Perfect. So now we're going to put the background graphics on. I'm going to put everything inside this table at the very end. I'm just going to put the background graphics on, then line everything up. So Insert, Shapes, click on the drop down and select the rectangle or the square. Click and drag out that rectangle. And then we're going to go to Gradient Fill again, click on the drop down, but this time we're going to change the gradient from Type, we're going to go to Radial. Then the Direction, we're going to select this middle one here. Then over here, we're going to select White, so select it, select White. And the yellow one here, click on the drop down, I'm going to select Blue. Now the borderline is actually a gradient, so go down to Line, go to Gradient Line. Now you can see I've got 4 markers here. I don't want 4, I just want 2. So in order to get rid of 2 of those, select it and go to this minus sign here. And again. And then again, we can put our gradients in. So go to color. I'm going to select the bright orange at the top. And then this one here, I'm going to select this lighter orange there or dark yellow. And then go along to the width and let's put 3 in. Actually, I think that was 5. So 5, there we go, and deselect. And then we've got that nice border around the outside, and you can see how the gradient works through that border. Now we've got to move this to the back. So select it, go to Shape Format, Send Backwards, click on the drop down, select Center Back. Now, most of the time that would work if we're working with text boxes and shapes, but because we're working with a table, we've got to go up to this wrap text icon here. Click on the drop down, go down and select behind text. Now the other thing is you can see the background in these boxes. We want these boxes to be completely white. So we need to select our table, go to table design, go to shading, click on the drop down and select white. And then the inside of those boxes will be white. Now we've got the body of it all inserted, let's line this all up. So select the background, go to shape format, align to center, align to middle. So again, I think I need to move this table down a little bit. So we're just going to go move this out of the way so I can get to my cursor, because this can be a bit annoying sometimes because you're clicking everywhere. Word thinks you want to select the background or one of the text boxes. So you sometimes have to move things out of the way. So let's just move this down a bit. Don't worry about the second page. We'll go over to the rulers again and pull down that margin. There we go. And then select the background, move it back over, and again, we'll just quickly align it again. Perfect. Oh, that's not gone to the... it's because we've moved our margins. So we can do this one by eye. So let's just move that one up with our arrow keys. There we go. Now I'm just going to move this cloud. So click on the cloud. Sometimes this can be a bit tricky because you click and you'll select the wrong thing. So make sure you've selected the right thing. There we go. There we go. Sometimes you just have to move whatever you grab hold of. Move bingo down. Now you can insert this in the middle or you can put it in the middle of the cloud. It's completely up to you. Now I'm just going to move this cloud around. So you can see there's this circular icon at the top. If you just pull that round, you can see that cloud moving. So it's a bit straighter. And then we'll select animal. Let me move that down. Oh, we are on the animal one. Looks like we've surrounded the bingo, but it's not. It's because of the curvature. So we've selected animal. So let's put that one in the middle as well. Align to center. Now I'm just going to put a thicker border on this cloud. Select it. Make sure you're on the bucket icon. Go to solid line and let's change that width. Let's put that up to 2. Yep, 2 is perfect. Okay, so now we've got everything in place. We can now put the words and all the icons into this grid. So select the table. And as you can see, all the text shading is at the top of our cells. So if I was to type now, everything would be at the top of our cells. I want everything to be in the middle. So select the table, go to layout, and go along to this section here and click in the middle and make sure the text is all in the middle. So when I type my first word, you can see now it's in the middle. What we can also do is select the table, go to the Home tab, and we can change all of the text to 18. So we don't have to change it every single time we type it. So simply adding a word in is fairly straightforward. So now let's add in an icon. So go to Insert, Icons, and at the search bar here, I'm going to type in animals. You can type in whatever you like, and you can see the variety that you have that you can choose from. So all you need to do is, let's say the cat, select the cat and go down to Insert. And the cat will automatically and beautifully insert into the center of your cell, which is really convenient. So this is really quite simple. I'll insert one more for you and then I'll go ahead and speed up the video. Insert, perfect. Then you can just go ahead and type all of your words. So I now go ahead and speed up the video and insert everything into my bingo grid. Okay, perfect. So everything's been inserted. Now all you need to do is print it out, or you can save it as a template where you can change these elements, or you can save it as a PDF. So if you go up to File, you can either go to Save as Template, click on it, and all you've got to do is make sure that it says Templates here and Microsoft Word Templates here. What that will mean is when you fire up Word, when you go onto the beginning page, it will show you all of your templates and this will be in there. And what it will mean is when you change it and save it, the original will be kept safe. The other way to save as a PDF, File, Save As, go to the bottom here and save as PDF. Name it what you want and then click export. If you want to download this, just simply check out the links below. I hope this has helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.